Looks like we're about to have a wedding, because I see the bride, and the groom's been here for ages. So I'm going to have you all remain seated for the wedding party, but as soon as I see the bride start up on her dad's arm, I'll have you stand for the bride, okay? Till then, just be well-behaved. Thank you. Please be seated, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, everybody, to Broken Top on this breezy afternoon. Thank you for coming from far and wide. And Richard and Carrie would especially like to thank their parents for all their help leading up to today. We are gathered here in the presence of God and family and friends to join in holy matrimony, Richard and Carrie, and to bear witness to the transforming power of love. This outward celebration of which we are partaking, we all know to be an expression of the inner love and devotion that each of them has in their heart for one another, and I know that that is exactly what has brought them to this very moment in their lives. Love is a quality of spirit and an attitude of the emotions, but a marriage is a life's work, a spiritual art form. Therefore, this is an occasion of both profound joy and great responsibility, and we who partake in it bind ourselves as witnesses to the labor of love that you are undertaking here. And yes, of course, all here present are with you, and we're with you to support you with our thoughts, our prayers, our energies, and our actions. Because we all know that this is such a special, an extremely important moment in each of your lives, because marriage is a commitment to life, to the best that two people can find and bring out in each other. Marriage offers opportunities for sharing and growth that no other human relationship can equal, a physical and emotional joining that is a promise for a lifetime. Within the circle of its love, marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships. A wife and a husband should be each other's best friend, as I know you are. A wife and a husband are each other's confidant, lover, teacher, listener, and critic. Marriage deepens and enriches every facet of life. Happiness is fuller, memories are fresher, commitment becomes stronger. Life in all ways is more full with marriage. Now, we're very lucky to have Shannon and Grace reading for us today. And they're going to be reading about love, and it's from 1 Corinthians.
Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud.
It is not rude, it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered.
It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in wrong, but rejoices with truth.
Love always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres.
Love never fails.
Beautiful. Thank you, ladies. Now, marriage isn't all that easy. Just ask anyone who's married here. But happiness in marriage must be created. In the art of marriage, it is the little things that make the difference. For instance, it's remembering to say I love you at least once a day, perhaps not always in words, but in the way you look at each other or touch. It is at no time taking the other for granted. The courtship should continue throughout your lives together. And I thoroughly recommend date night once a week without fail. I know you're busy and all, but come on now. It is never growing too old to hold hands, and it is never going to sleep angry. It's having a mutual sense of values and common objectives. And it's forming a circle which gathers in the whole family and the family of friends. Happiness in marriage is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It's doing things for each other not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. Carrie, it is not expecting the husband to wear a halo. So just don't expect it. And Richard, it's not expecting the wife to have the wings of an angel, even though we know she does. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and of course your sense of humor. And it's having the capacity to forgive and forget. It's giving each other an atmosphere in which to grow. And it is establishing a relationship in which the independence is equal, the dependence is mutual, and the obligation is reciprocal. Happiness must be nurtured and cherished on a daily basis. In marriage, the initial friendship should never be forgotten or taken for granted. Communication with each other should be constant, with the words spoken in a loving way always. Happiness in marriage is always remembering the love you have for each other today and not allowing the trials and tribulations of everyday life to cloud that memory. Now, Vaishali and Kevin are going to read for us.
I carry your heart with me.
I carry it in my heart.
I am never without it.
Anywhere you go, my dear, and whatever is done by only me is your doing, my darling.
I fear no fate.
For you are my fate, my sweet.
I want no world.
For beautiful you are my world, my true.
And it's you are whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows.
Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or the mind can hide.
And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart.
I carry it in my heart.
Thank you very much. Now, in acknowledgement of this holy purpose and of the great power of this occasion, let's just say a little prayer. Dear God, we give you thanks for the love and the joy that Carrie and Rich have found in one another, and for their open hearts and willing spirits, and for the example of love that they embody here in our presence. Please be with them on this joyous occasion of showing their love and making their vows, and be with us, their witnesses, that we may all be changed by what is said and witnessed here today. May this marriage be held in your hands, dear God, and ministered unto by your angels. In Jesus Christ our Lord we pray and give thanks. Amen. Well, you know, being married up here in the Northwest is a sure sign that this will grow into a wonderful, loving life, a life where you can be happy every day, a life in which you can be forever young at heart, enjoying each day, each week, each season together. And your choice of location today is proof enough that you're ready to embark on a journey together full of fun and happiness, with love and laughter your constant companions. So without further ado, I have a question. You've been waiting long enough, I think. Richard, do you take Carrie to be your wife? Do you promise to love her and stand by her side through good times or bad? Do you vow to be there for her always as her loving partner and friend?
I do.
And Carrie, do you take Richard to be your husband? Do you promise to love him and stand by his side through good times or bad? Do you vow to be there for him always as his loving partner and friend?
I do.
Thank you. Now, if I may have the rings, please. Thank you. Is that the total? Thank you very much. You may now relax. I ask that these rings be blessed as the symbol of this affectionate unity. May these two find in each other the love for which all men and women yearn. May the home which they establish together be such a place of sanctuary that many will find there a friend. May these rings symbolize the everlasting love that you have found in each other. All right, sir, just a few words after me, placing that ring on your bride's left hand. The one with the special, I like that. To make sure. Gazing into her eyes, holding onto that ring, please repeat after me. I, Richard, take you, Carrie.
I, Richard, take you, Carrie.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
To be my lawfully wedded wife.
And with this ring I seal the vow.
And with this ring I seal the vow.
That I will always be yours and yours alone.
That I will always be yours and yours alone.
Now you have your own words to say, sir. Uh-oh.
Carrie, I remember clearly the first moment I saw you on that crosswalk on Westwood. I knew I had finally found someone special. Headstrong and steadfast, you walked toward me. Enchanted and motionless, I stood. Somehow I made it through that first lunch date without chasing you away. And now we're here on the best day of my life. I believe in you, the person you will grow to be and the couple we will be together. Each day I've longed to give you everything you've wanted, and today I give you my heart. Today I make you these promises. I promise to encourage your compassion, because that is what makes you unique and special. I promise to partner with you in all things and to help shoulder our challenges. There is nothing we cannot face if we stand together. I promise that no matter how big or how many sequins you have on your latest handbag, I will carry it when you need me to. Finally, I promise to make your world a better place and to love you every day more than the one before, because one lifetime with you is not enough. Carrie, you're my best friend, my closest confidant, and my favorite Disneyland companion. I can't imagine spending the rest of my life without you. You're the reason I'm the luckiest guy in the world. Thank you for marrying me.
I'm all excited. I don't know about everybody else. I'd like you to place that on Rich's left hand, please. The quivering one there, that's the one. That's it. Holding onto that ring, gazing into his eyes, please repeat after me. I, Carrie, take you, Richard.
I, Carrie, take you, Richard.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
To be my lawfully wedded husband.
And with this ring, I seal the vow.
And with this ring, I seal the vow.
That I will always be yours and yours alone.
That I will always be yours and yours alone.
Now you have some words.
Richard, 5 years ago, I was just a girl looking for a boy to spend some time with. Little did I know I would end up meeting the man I would spend the rest of my life with. I vow to grow old with you, but never let either one of us forget how to be young together. I vow to see the world with you, but always remember to show you that you are the world to me. I vow to be your pillar when you need strength, and your pillow when you need a place to rest your tired body. I vow to support your spirit and individuality. I vow to love you, respect you, and protect you. I vow to work at this every day because I want you, all of you, forever. There is no hand I'd rather hold than yours, or home I'd rather share than ours. With you by my side, I feel like anything is possible, and I can't wait to be one of those couples with 50 years under our wedding bands. Our story began with a simple message. I get out of class at 10 o'clock. I would like to buy a copier from you. Today I have a simple message for you. To me, you are perfect. The only thing I would change about our story is finding you sooner so I could love you longer. I love you and I cannot wait to spend my life with you.
That was awesome. Your two lives are now being joined in one unbroken circle. Hold on to each other's hands, please. I can't stand it any longer. Wherever you go, may you always return to one another in your togetherness. As the two of you have placed the wedding band on each other's finger, you have become one in the spirit of love. May the love that fills your lives today continue to go on forever, just like the circle of those wedding bands. Once more, just briefly, a prayer. Dear God, we thank you for this miraculous day, for the fulfillment of love we see before us, and for the joy of sharing this very happy occasion. May your spirit be with Carrie and Richard. May they always know your peace and harmony, and may you protect them always. We now place them and their entire family in your loving hands. Amen. Well, you two adorable people, you've made this commitment in the name of love. You will triumph in the times of hardship, and I know you will revel in the times of joy. Love is peace, and peace is love. May harmony and happiness be with you always. So now already there's just one thing left to say, but you know I'm going to make you all wait. It's just the way I am. It's because we're standing here right at this very beautiful spot on the planet. I'm going to conclude with a brief but very beautiful Native American Indian blessing. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no more loneliness. Now you are two persons, but there is only one life before you. Go now to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your life together, and may those days be good and long upon the earth. So now all that remains, by the power vested in me, by the great state of Oregon, it is my honor, my privilege, and you know it's my great pleasure to now pronounce you husband and wife. Richard, it's time for you to kiss your bride, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Richard and Carrie Broussard.